duck. He really loves to eat fruit and play with all his friends.
There's Pocoyo and Pato. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
You're drawing a picture today, are you, Pocoyo? How lovely. A picture of Pocoyo and his good friend Ellie. I'm sure Ellie would love to see that. It would be great, wouldn't it, if you could send it to her? If there was someone who could deliver it to Ellie for you. What you really need is someone who would like to be a postman for the day. But who around here would want to be a postman, Pocoyo? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who might be our postman?
Pato!
Yes! And something tells me he really, really wants the job. Well, you'd best be off. You've got a delivery to make, Pato the postman.
Thank you.
And so, Pato is taking his first very important delivery to Ellie. It's a long way, isn't it, Pato? Well done, Pato! You've made your first delivery. Yes, how nice. And it looks like you're about to make your second delivery, too. It's a letter from Ellie to Pocoyo. This whole postman idea certainly is fun, isn't it? Oh, Pocoyo, it is exciting to get a letter in return, isn't it? Well, you know, they do say the best way to get a letter is to send a letter. And the more you send... Pocoyo? Well, if you send that many letters, I'm sure you'll get lots in return. Oh, I don't think Pocoyo has any more letters today, Pato. He's got a parcel! Oh, no Ellie. Well, that is a very big parcel. I suppose it's for Pocoyo. Pato, that's too difficult even for an expert postman like yourself. I wonder what could be in such a large box. It's almost as big as Ellie. Even sounds like her. Another delivery for you, Pocoyo. What do you think's in the box, Pocoyo? Good idea, Pocoyo. We'll ask our friends. So, can any of you guess what's inside this gigantic box?
Ellie!
Why, it is Ellie herself! I bet the ears gave it away, didn't they? Oh dear, Pato seems to be rather angry. Oh, look, Pato! I think there might be another delivery after all. Looks like a special delivery. Now, who can it be for? Here's to Pato, a great postman and an even greater friend. Hooray for Pato! Hooray for Ellie! Hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon! that. What is it? I wonder who it could be. Can any of you help me? Who is that singing?
It's Pato!
Pato! So it was you. I had no idea you could sing like that. There you are. There's nothing Pato loves more than getting clean. How many showers is that today for you, Pato? Three? Oh, I'm sorry. Four, of course. You'd better get going, though. Pocoyo and Ellie are waiting for you. Yes, indeed. Being clean certainly makes Pato happy. Pato, look out for that! Phew! That was a close one. I think Ellie and Pocoyo are having lunch. I wonder what they're having. Don't you want a sandwich, Pato? Pato? Oh, I see. Too messy, is it? Pato, why don't you come out now? I'm sure Pocoyo and Ellie have finished eating now. Yes, they're bound to be playing something else by now. Now, where can they be? Finger painting, getting messy and having fun. Oh, dear. Yes. It's all right, you two. It's just that I don't think poor Pato wants to finger paint either. You see, he just took a shower. What is it, Ellie? 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 Pocoyo? You know, Pato, you needn't be so worried about getting dirty. Yes, I know you're clean, but Pocoyo and Ellie have finished painting. I wonder what they're playing now. It can't be anything as messy as painting, can it?
Muppie!
Oh, dear! Well, that was amazing, Pato. Not a spot of mud on you. Uh-oh. Wait a minute. Well, Pato was trying so hard to keep clean, but can any of you tell him what's happened? Yes, I'm afraid to say, Pato, you've got a spot of mud on you. Look. Pato? 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 You know, I was trying to tell you before, getting dirty isn't such a bad thing. No, no, it's true. Think of it this way. You like getting clean, don't you? Well, how much fun would it be to get clean if you didn't get just a little bit dirty first? Oh, look, how nice. Your friends even brought you a bathtub. I suppose Pato worked out that if getting a little dirty makes bath time a little more fun, then getting a lot dirty will make it a lot more fun. Hooray for getting dirty and for getting clean. Hooray for Pato. Hooray for Pocoyo. See you in the tub later. Bye-bye. What have we here? Looks like Baby Bird, Pato and Pocoyo. Hello!
Hi!
Just look at them! Having a ball. Be careful, though. We wouldn't want to see you get hurt or... Pato, what are you doing up there? How did you... You're upside down. I know. This is very strange.
Pato?
Pocoyo? Pato is... he is around, just not where you'd expect. He's sort of, up there. He's, stuck. You don't believe me, do you? Can any of you help me? Can you tell Pocoyo where Pato is?
He's up there!
He's upside down!
You see what I mean? Oh dear, what are we going to do about this?
Jump, Pato, jump!
Wait, I know. Maybe Ellie can help us. She's so tall. Perhaps she could grab Pato and bring him back down. Hurry, Pocoyo, go and find Ellie. Now take it easy, Pato. Ellie, we need your help. It's difficult to explain, really. Perhaps you should come and see for yourself. Yes, that's what Pocoyo was trying to tell you. You're going to jump. Ready, Pato? Ready, Ellie? Let's all count. One, two, three! Oh, dear. This isn't quite working the way I'd imagined. Where's Ellie going? Oh, I see. Oh, Pato, wait. She's... No, I think you've got the wrong... No. I think Ellie has a plan. Go on, Pato. Ready, Pato? Jump! Oh, dear. That didn't seem to work either. Oh, I see. Pato's using his flying power. Go on, Pato! Oh, dear. Oh, poor Pato. Pocoyo, perhaps we should try to cheer Pato up a bit. Do any of you think that's a good plan?
Yes, cheer him up.
Now, now, Pato, don't cry. Oh, look, Pato, Pocoyo has brought you your favourite flowers and your watering can. Feeling better, Pato? And Ellie has brought you something to drink in your favourite sippy cup. And look at this. So thoughtful. You're so lucky to have such good friends, Pato. Pocoyo, what are you doing with that alarm clock? I see. You've played, and now it's time for some rest. Pato! Look at yourself! You came down!
Yay!
Well, what are you waiting for? You definitely showed Pato how much you care for him. Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for friends!
Bye!
Bye-bye! See you soon! Hello, Pocoyo.
Hello.
Hello, Pato. Oh, what's that?
Scooter, scooter, scooter.
Whose is that lovely pink scooter?
Ellie's.
And I wonder what it's doing here. Perhaps she's forgotten it. What do you think? Should they take it back to her?
Take
it to Ellie. Uh-oh. Good work, Pato. You're quite the expert on the scooter. Looks like Pato is ready to show what an expert can do. Woohoo! Wow, fantastic! Woohoo-wee! You really know how to handle that scooter, Pato. I like your caterpillar scooter, baby bird. Pato thinks you should stick to taking pictures of him, at least until you're bigger. Oh, my. That does look impressive. Oh dear, I don't think Ellie's going to be happy about this. But Pato, that's Ellie's scooter. Pato's having too much fun to remember. Oh my goodness. Oh no! Oh, Pato, no! That was Ellie's scooter, remember, Pato?
Ellie!
Oh, whatever are you going to do? You really think Ellie will like your, sculpture as much as her scooter? Can any of you tell Pocoyo who's coming?
Ellie's coming.
Pato, is that you? Hello, Ellie. Ellie, maybe you shouldn't get on your scooter just this minute. Oh, Ellie! Oh, dear. You see, Ellie, your scooter is, broken. They'll get it fixed. Don't worry. They tried their best. Really, they did. You shouldn't hug them. You mean you're not angry that your scooter's broken? What's going on? Oh, I see. Can any of you tell Pocoyo what Ellie has there? Yeah, right. And quite a fancy scooter at that. Oh, dear. All that worry for nothing. Hooray for Pocoyo. Hooray for telling the truth. Bye-bye. See you soon.
Hi,
Ellie. And hello, Pato. Oh, I see. You're going to race. What fun. Oops! Okay, everybody ready? When I count three, let's all shout go, shall we? Ready? One, two, three! Go! And the winner is... Pocoyo! Pato's ready to go on to the jumping contest. Well done, Pocoyo! Excellent jump, Pato. We might be looking at a winner. What's this? Bad luck, Pato. Ellie wins. Oh dear, Pato is a very bad loser. What's this? Looks like some very fancy running shoes. Why not try them on, Pato? Nice. Oh dear. Oh no, Pato! Those shoes seem to have a mind of their own. Looks like you've got them under control, Pato. Wow! Pato wants to know if you two would like to have a little race. All right then, everyone, join in again. Ready, steady, go! Pato wins! Yes, Pato, we know you're the winner. I think we can already declare the winner. Pato wins! I don't think they want to race against you anymore, Pato. Ellie has noticed your super shoes. Looks like those shoes don't want to be taken off. Out of control! What's this? work, baby bird and caterpillar. You did it. I suppose you learned something here today, Pato. It's just not worth cheating.
Play!
Excellent idea, Pocoyo. What do you think? Should Pato keep his shoes?
No!
Don't keep them!
Well done! Hooray for Pato! Hooray for fair play! Bye-bye! See you soon! There are Pocoyo and his friends. It looks like they're building a tower together. Hello, Pocoyo.
Hi.
Hi, Ellie. Hi, Pato. Good catch, Ellie. Everyone is definitely working together to build this tower. Oh, what's wrong with Pato, Pocoyo? What are those funny noises he's making? Can any of you tell Pocoyo and the others what's going on with Pato?
Hiccups! He's got the hiccups!
That's right! Pato does have the hiccups.
Hiccups.
Oh, don't worry, Pato. Hiccups are nothing to worry about. But they are rather annoying. Do you want to get rid of your hiccups, Pato? Maybe together we can think of a way to help Pato get rid of his hiccups. Oh, sounds like Ellie might have an idea. Oh, what is Ellie doing? Oh, Ellie wants Pato to hold his breath. Nice idea, Ellie. Do you want to try it, Pato? Okay, Pato. Take a big breath on the count of three. One, two, three. Well done, Pato. That should do it. Oh dear. And it seemed like such a good idea. Oh, you have an idea too, Pocoyo. Oh, what is Pocoyo doing? Oh, I see. You think Pato can get rid of his hiccups by standing on his head. Well, what do you think, Pato? Want to give it a try? I say, I think this time it might have worked. Oh, well. That seemed like a very good idea too, Pocoyo. What's that, Ellie? Do you think hopping on one foot might get rid of the hiccups? What do you think, Pato? It does look a bit silly, but you never know. Perhaps everyone should jump on one foot to make Pato feel better. Well, it was worth a try. What's Pocoyo doing now? Oh, he's holding his breath, standing on his head, and jumping on one foot all at the same time. What do you think, Pato?
Psst. Hey, come here. Pocoyo, while Pato is doing that, I might know a way to get rid of the hiccups, but it's a surprise and Pato can't know about it. One way to stop hiccups is to give someone a surprise. You know, like come up behind him and say, boo! No, come back. Pato can't know that you're going to startle him. It has to be a surprise. Oh, hiding! What a good idea, Pocoyo. Why didn't I think of that? I've got another idea. Why don't all of you help Pocoyo and Ellie say boo? So let's all say boo after three. Ready? One, two, three. Oh, our boo didn't scare him, but it started the tower swaying right behind Pato. Pato, watch out!
No hiccups!
It worked! The surprise that surprised everyone cured Pato's hiccups! Hooray for working together! Hooray for Pocoyo! Hooray for hiccups! Bye-bye! Oh no, now I've got them! See you soon! Everyone. Oh, and Pato. Hello. Oops. Oh dear, Pato. You do seem to be having a hard time keeping up. Oh no, Pato. I didn't mean that you're too young to keep up with the others. What's that? Oh, it's a pair of sunglasses. And very grown-up looking, too. Is that how you wear sunglasses?
No!
Is that right?
No! No!
How about that?
No!
Is that how you wear sunglasses?
Yes!
You look very stylish and very grown up, Pato. What was that, Pato? You think you need a new name? Something that goes with your new style. Oh, I know. Mr. Waddles. How about Sir Quacks-a-Lot? No. Senor Shades. Oh, wait, I've got it. How about Mr. Big Duck? Pato wants to know if you like the name Mr. Big Duck.
Yes, we like it.
Yes, I think that's it. Mr. Big Duck. The perfect name for a very grown-up duck.
Pato, play.
I think what Mr. Big Duck is trying to say, Pocoyo, is that he's too grown up to play with blocks. Mr. Big Duck, why don't you show Pocoyo what a big grown-up you are? Oh, you want to be a grown-up too, Pocoyo? Wow, you look very grown up, Pocoyo. Oops. Hello, baby bird. Wow! Look at these cool grown-ups. Yes, yes, baby bird, we know. You're a grown-up too. Well, here we are. All grown up. Yes, sirree. Three cool dudes. Oh, phew! Hello, Ellie. I think Ellie wants you to play. Oh, yes, I forgot. It seems Mr. Big Duck and the others are too grown up to play. What's this? Oh, look! Ellie's finger painting. What fun! Oh, it seems these three are too grown up for things like finger paints. Look! Now Ellie's playing with building blocks. My favourite. Oh, lovely. Nothing better than playing with a splendid train set. Look, Mr. Big Duck, I know you're all grown up and everything, but don't you think you're taking this a little too far? Now, Mr. Big Duck, don't be upset. Pocoyo couldn't help himself. He's not really a grown-up. He's just pretending. Just like you. Oh, look, a ball. Why don't you play with... that's to say, bounce the ball. Don't worry, Mr. Big Duck. Grown-ups bounce balls too. What do you think? Do you think Pato should join his friends?
Yes, he should.
Hooray for Pato! Hooray for friends! And hooray for Pocoyo! Bye-bye! See you soon!
Bye!